So you've been watching the news about I-95 in Philadelphia, where the bridge caught on fire and fell down, and now I-95 is closed and the entire Northeast is panicking. Well, it got me a little bit distracted, and instead of editing the next video for you, I stayed up all night last night making this, because I want to show you what's been happening, what's happening now, and what's going to happen to get this freeway back open in less than 2 weeks. This is not the typical story of, oh no, America's infrastructure is falling apart and the bridge just fell down because it was old and rusty. This is basically brand new. PennDOT just replaced this bridge 9 years ago. So what happened? Well, about a week ago, a tanker truck was coming off this off-ramp, turned a little too fast, crashed, and because it was hauling gasoline, the gasoline caught fire and it started burning up underneath this overpass. And you might ask, well, what does fire have to do with concrete? The bridge is made out of concrete. Well, it's not entirely concrete. Inside of concrete is steel rebar. It's about this big around. You can think about it like this. When you have a big truck in the middle of the bridge and it's pushing down, the bridge wants to bend a little bit. It deflects, it deforms. And the top of the beam, it wants to squish together. That's called compression. If you think about concrete, you can squish it all day long and it's really strong. But the bottom is doing the total opposite. It's wanting to be pulled apart. That's called tension. And concrete's really bad at that. You try to yank on concrete, it just crumbles apart. But you know what doesn't do that? Metal. Metal is fantastic at being pulled on. But what metal is bad at is being squished. You can almost take a piece of rebar and just go and bend it yourself. So if you take the squishy superpower strength of concrete and combine it with the pulling apart tension strength of metal, mix them together and you end up with steel reinforced concrete. Well, it's a pretty amazing material. Unless the metal gets hot. You might have seen video like this on the news of the bridge starting to sag. That's because the top part, the concrete still has its strength to squish together in compression. But the bottom part, well, the metal's getting weaker and weaker. So it's pulling apart. And if it starts to sag too much, the whole thing can just, you know, fall off. And that's what happened. Now the southbound traffic on I-95 is no longer possible. But it gets even worse because the fire burned so hot that even though the northbound side was still standing, PennDOT still had to demolish it. So now we're stuck with no northbound or southbound bridges along I-95 on the East Coast. This isn't the first time a state's had to deal with something like this. Famously, Georgia's Interstate 85 in Atlanta had almost the exact same situation. The MacArthur-Mays interchange in the Bay Area, similar situation. It's really too bad that this street doesn't go over I-95, because when a situation like that happened in Orange County, California, Caltrans just demolished that ramp and the problem went away. But this is a situation where the bridge carries I-95, not the off-ramp. So we have to fix I-95.
We're also looking at interim solutions to connect both sides to get traffic through the area.
So the governor of Pennsylvania said, well, we'll have I-95 reopen in less than 2 weeks. And I thought, how are you going to rebuild a bridge in 2 weeks? Well, it turns out they're not going to rebuild the bridge in 2 weeks, but it'll still be open. This is pretty clever. Okay, so you build a couple of retaining walls in the middle and you start filling it up with recycled glass, which is basically sand, right? And what that does is it spans the gap between the two freeways. This ramp underneath the freeway, it's gonna be closed anyway while they're rebuilding the bridges. But you don't fill the entire thing in. You just fill in this middle part here. You can pave over the top of that recycled glass that you've put in there, and now you've spanned the distance so traffic can drive on asphalt from one side to the other. And as promised, that lets I-95 be back open within 2 weeks. But it's still not fixed. You still have to rebuild the bridges. But that's the cool part. See these outside sections that don't have sand filling it in? Those can become the work zones. With the outside halves of the new bridges finished, they can move the traffic onto those half bridges on each side, and then they don't need this middle part anymore, so it can go. leaving them with a work zone in the middle so they can now finish the project. And there you go. With both construction phases over, I-95 is totally back open like it never happened. There's a whole art to this. It's called construction phasing. The people who do it, it's basically open heart surgery. It's really cool if you ever want to Google that. Well, I think I'm going to go get a Philly cheesesteak sandwich and then get back to editing the real video I'm supposed to be working on. But thanks for indulging me, and I'll see you next time.
So, are you from Philly? Can you tell me how authentic this cheesesteak sandwich is? Because I've never been to Philly. I've never had a real one. This sandwich, but more importantly this video, are both made possible by you. Thanks for your continuing support at patreon.com/roadguyrob.